While out shopping for the usual electronic tat that I like so much, I discovered this Hyundai four-way extension socket with surge protection. And since I already took one apart recently, I thought it'd be interesting to see another version. And this is the second take of the video because I really fluffed the first video up. But on the plus note, you actually get to not see me hunting around for the correct screwdriver, which is triangular screws heads. And also it saves you having to watch them all get taken out. And me then cut the electronic module out. So here's the surge protection module, and if you recall, the last one just had three metal oxide varistors, as does this one. And I was saying that, you know, normally they'd have electronic fuses just for extra protection when these start to fail. This one has electronic fuses. Now, one notable feature in here, I'm not sure it should be called a feature as such, is that when this was in here, it has a little bit of heat shrink around it. The neutral had actually been nipped and the screw was driven right through the actual wire here. But that's, you know, the neutral's not the hazardous one. It's theoretically normally at ground potential anyway. And the screw's recessed, so it's not a big thing, but it is a bit sloppy in the manufacturing. Another notable thing is that the module here also has the little lead going out to a neon with a little inline resistor here. And it's a green neon. It's one of the little NE2 lamps with the green phosphor inside. Quite nice. And if we look at the schematic for this, let's see if I can make sure this is lined up here. Yeah, that looks pretty good. If we look at the schematic, you can see there are the three metal oxide varistors and they're between live, neutral and earth. However, on each of the live and neutral, we have the two thermal fuses sandwiched between the metal oxide varistors. The metal oxide varistors are smaller than the ones in the last unit, which means they've got a lower ability to absorb, you know, a significant number of surges. This would probably last less time than the other one that didn't have the thermal protection, but this one's less likely to set your house on fire afterwards. But the nature of these metal oxide varistors is that every time they absorb a transient, every time their voltage is exceeded, then they... I'm just going to slip the cable from this microphone. It's just wangled its way off my shoulder here. Every time they clip a transient, their voltage is exceeded, they just end up just failing a little bit internally. They gradually break down over time. And that results ultimately when they've really failed in the heat, and that in that case, these thermal fuses will blow. And these are the thermal fuses here. I wasn't sure what the actual symbol for a thermal fuse is, so I just drew a fuse and wrote degrees centigrade next to it. And another notable feature here is that the neon is actually after the thermal fuses. So theoretically, when one of the thermal fuses trips, then the green neon goes out to indicate that there's no longer any surge protection. However, that's slightly defeated, theoretically, if there was any leakage through this. And this thermal fuse went, you'd end up losing the live to neutral protection. But theoretically, the live could find a path through the neon. And if this was leaking slightly, it could find a route to Earth. So it's not an infallible approach, having the neon like that. But it should ultimately work, I guess. The metal oxide varistors involved are HEL10D471K, where the 471 usually indicates 47 and 10, 470 volts, which is the sort of rough mean voltage before they'll actually start conducting. And if you consider that this is designed for 240 volt use in the UK, and our sort of peak mains voltage is about 330 volts, it's got a modest margin before it will actually kick in to start clipping transients. So really, it's a better design than the other one. Now I'm wondering what was in the others that were on the same shelf. That was the only one branded Hyundai, and the other ones all had those horrible little press rivets that had been put into the plastic that make it very hard opening the cases. That was the only one held together by screws. So I'm wondering what was in the other ones. But certainly this one, it's pretty typical. This is ultimately what you find in a fairly good modern transient suppressor. It's not a terribly expensive device to add to a socket. Certainly not as much as, you know, you see some of these surge protectors with ridiculous prices for what is probably just this inside. But it's a perfectly functional little unit. It's got that thermal protection that I like, and it's got the little neon that will at least give an indication if the protection has tripped due to a lot of transients or maybe a lightning strike or something. But yeah, it looks pretty typical and pretty good unit.